Good evening, it's Saturday night, it's the 6th of November, and we're at North Petherton. We're here for the carnival this evening. My name is Malcolm Jones, and I shall be doing the commentary this evening with my good friend from Radio Bristol and Somerset Sound, Sheila Lee Ewers. Sheila.
Thank you, Malcolm. Yes, I've been already talking to some of the people here on the side of the pavements tonight. It looks like a great night. I've walked down through the floats. They're up to their normal standard. Excellent. I have to say that North Petherton is one of my favourite carnivals. The crowd's in a good mood. The sky is clear. It should be a really good night tonight.
Yes, I can hear the carnival coming down the road now. So let's pop into our commentary position and watch the greatest show on earth. Come on, Sheila. And this is the moment that we've been waiting for. Sheila, this is the moment of the great excitement, the night of night for North Petherton. The carnival has begun. The very first thing we see, or we did see, is the fire engine that always leads the procession, which no doubt we will pick up because we like to pay service to the Somerset Fire Brigade, because you never know when you need them, do you?
Absolutely. It's a good evening here in North Petherton. I mean, the sky again, we were spoilt for the weather on Thursday night at Bridgewater. Here's the fire engine just coming through, leading through the very first float. Again, it's a good dry night. Temperatures are a little bit cold. You can see the crowd just in between the fire engine and the first float, wrapped up warmly tonight. At least if you're on the float and the music is loud and fast, you can move about and warm up.
Yes, here's the first of the mounted entries this evening. It's from the Pirates Carnival Club of Weston-super-Mare, and they're Justified and Ancient. A little fantasy idea, the fantasy world of Mumu Land, with the sacred skull warding off evil and protecting the high temple.
Well, the music, which we can't actually hear at the moment, I'm sure it'll come into play, Justified and Ancient, originally done by KLF, and then they did a new version, remixed and brought in Tammy Wynette, and it did very well in the charts.
And this is just some of the example of some of the great shots that you're going to be seeing this evening.
You've got tribal drummers, six girl dancers, all dancing to the beat of the drums, and the king of the Mumu Land, Keith Wilson, overseeing the celebrations, looking very much at home.
He's a grand looking king, isn't he? Fearsome devil.
I like the beads.
Great, and that's the generator. This is one of the features nowadays, as we say so often, that every part of the 100 feet is covered. There's not an inch of wasted space. We move on to the second entry now. This is the priorities of Taunton, and they are Shooting Stars. How about this? This is a grand little walking entry. Beautiful sort of choreography, a nice little spaceship at the front. Great, and they really are together.
And their youngest member is a mere 9 years of age. Ken Gamblin's their club captain.
But we won't be able to pick them out, we just talk them as a group.
Intergalactic star beings and their craft is the theme for this entry.
And very, very good. Excellent.
Nice idea to continue the makeup across the face and tie in with the costumes on that.
Yes, we're searching for our next walk-in entry, which will be coming along now. Here they are. This is the...
A very regal couple.
It's Queen Elizabeth. Queen Elizabeth I, and she is from the Watsit Carnival Club. And they gave me a bottle of Cointreau just now, so I would say very, very thank you. And there's one for Sheila as well. And the person
really? We're open to bribery here.
It's Sir Walter Raleigh.
Lawrence Harris playing Sir Walter Raleigh. Can you say playing? I suppose you can. Chesterfield in charge.
Yes, and we're on to the Dragons Carnival Club. This is the local one, the first of the local entries. They're from the Dragons, of course, Dragons Carnival Club of North Petherton. And Mr. Blobby is on tour. Last year they were monster mashing, and this year they're in a direct contrast with a comedy theme of dear old Mr. Blobby.
Noel Edmonds has a lot to answer for. Mr. Blobby's been a very popular person at all the summer fetes throughout Somerset through the summer. Very European theme to this. You can just see there the leaning, or you could just see there the leaning Tower of Pisa.
Oh, that's what it is. Mr. Blobby's family tour of Europe. Oh, I didn't realise that. I've been looking at it here without seeing it. And there's the little Blobby bus at the end.
Yes, you've got the windmill, Big Ben, which looks as if it needs a little bit of adjustment. The odd tweak here or there. There you go, there's the leaning tower.
Yeah, and the Blobby bus following up behind. And closely followed is another local entry. It's the Young Dragons Carnival Club. Young Dragons of North Petherton, we know these well. They've been in Carnival for 6 years. Last year's entry was a great entry, as the Pinball Wizard. This year they are pirates, and fearsome looking pirates they are as well. Look at that little fella with the one eye and the scar. Ha ha, gym lad.
Now, Attell, their youngest member is 3. I wonder if that constitutes the youngest member.
There he is.
That we're going to see tonight. Aww.
A vast behind.
It doesn't look that threatening.
I wasn't
though,
talking
I have to
about
say.
You, Sheila. No, we'd just like to say special thanks there to Mr. Kirk. Jay Kirk and M. Parsons for making the costumes. I nearly missed that. Okay, thank you.
That looks as if he's enjoying himself.
That's some music from the 50s, the great sound of Bill Haley and the Comets, and the great music of Jive Bunny from the Topsy Turvy Carnival Club of Ilminster.
Oh.
Sheila is here bobbing in her seat.
One of my favourites. I love Jive Bunny. Really bouncing. Now, last year they did Hot Dog, which was another really noisy and bouncy entry. Oh, hell, Marco, I'm just going to go down on the floor. I'm going to disappear during this evening. The music for this is really good.
They're based at Two Hoots at Dawlish Wake. Dawlish Wake, beg your pardon. Whatever happened to Jive Bunny? Wasn't he one of the great characters of our time? He sold millions and millions of...
They did copies. Very well with that.
Probably retired somewhere. He's got a little bunny harem somewhere, I expect.
I think it's called copyright problems, but still. Oh, look, there's the Wurlitzer.
Yes.
Every home should have a Wurlitzer. It's brilliant.
Have you got one?
No, sadly not.
I'll tell you something. I used to have a Wurlitzer in my front room, and my assistant here, Trevor, had one that... And then we got rid of them. They're crazy people.
Oh, marvellous piece of machinery.
There's a little... Oh, he's jiving with her. I wonder what he was doing with that rabbit there.
Well, the Quantro Kid rules again. Does this make me the Quantro Kid-ess? Thank you to whoever it was that gave me my Quantro. No, you're supposed to throw it over the shoulder. That's a bit of a movement there. Oh, do you remember that? Doing the twist, Chubby Checker? 1962.
Yes, I was just reading the records at the side. Is Jive Bunny and At the Hop, Rabbit Rabbit, Echo and the Bunny Man. At the Hop, Elvis Presley. I don't quite see what Elvis is doing there.
I think I'd recommend the ladies in the crowd to do some bopping. They'd warm up.
The Streamers Carnival Club of Ilminster and their magnificent juvenile entry, Follow the Band. Follow the Band from the show Barnum, of course. And here they are. It really is a juvenile. They really are little fellas from 4 years old to 9 years old. And the club captain is Fred Oliver.
And the model maker for this entry was Jeff Hardwell, costumes by Kim Scotting.
And they'd like to say thank you to Mr. and Mrs. Troot of White House Farm for the building base, and Mr. Hallett for the loan of his tractor. And that's right, you people are so kind to help these youngsters enjoy themselves and stay out of mischief. Thank you very much.
And they were formed just last year by a group of friends who just wanted to give their kids something to do and get them involved in the carnival spirit.
That's the thing. Golden Triangle Carnival Club of Ilminster, another one, and this is a Showboat. Last year's entry was the Student Prince. It's a lot of juveniles. It's a good idea to have the juveniles at the beginning of the procession, because they'll be tired right out of the end, like we will.
Now, if this to me conjures up sort of the Mississippi.
Yes.
The southern comfort.
Yes.
Can't you just feel
the
heat?
You're very drink-oriented, aren't you? A little problem
there. Well, those rumours you've heard about me are true, darling.
We're having a long shot here at the Centurions Carnival Club. They're from Bridgewater, and their entry this year is the year 1605. Of course, the year 1605 was the gunpowder plot where old Guy Fawkes tried to blow up the Houses of Parliament.
And their base, of course, is the Mansion House. And their ages, we're told, span 18 through to 70, which proves you're never too old to stay with the carnival spirit.
Guy Fawkes was a Yorkshireman. He was converted to be a Catholic at the age of 21. He fought with the Spanish army against Protestants in Flanders. He came back, he was disillusioned, so he tried to blow up Parliament, as we all know the story. There he is underneath with his candles and barrels of powder.
I like the two-tiered effect
of this.
Yes, very
clever.
It's good, isn't it? They've obviously worked hard at it. Whoever did the painting, the designing, has worked hard.
At the back, there's King James, who's just disappeared at the back.
Oh, Cockney Capers.
Well, no, we're going back to King James and the Houses of Parliament, because after all, without Guy Fawkes trying to blow this up, we wouldn't have a carnival here this evening, would we?
True.
Well, the good folks of Somerset would find some other reason to go out on the streets and get...
We're a rebellious crowd in the county.
Just down the road from the Houses of Parliament, we have Lambeth Way and Cockney Capers. This is the British Flag Carnival Club and their entry, Cockney Capers. British Flag, who went through a little bit of trouble this year for lack of funds and people, decided to stay on to make an entry a little bit smaller than it usually is, but nonetheless they're having a good time and they are saying, look out, next year we shall return.
Music, of course, by Max Bygraves that you can hear. A special mention for Ray Baker, who's worked with the club for 30 years, who has earned himself the nickname of Lala, we're told. Would somebody like to tell us why? That's really one of those good bouncy floats, isn't it? I mean, if you haven't got a lot of money, this shows what you can do. You've got the right gear and the right spirit.
Yes, and if you're looking for a good club to join, join the British Flag. They need a few new members. That's one of our old road crew there, the first guy in green. This is Lisa and Elizabeth Arness, the Rescuers. They're from 41 Stoke Road, Taunton, and they're based on the Disney cartoon, The Rescuers. There they are, the little mice. The girls would like to thank Nanny Arness for knitting the 16-foot-long blue scarf around Wilbur's neck. Well, Wilbur is the albatross, a little bit lower. If we could go a little bit lower and see the albatross, and we'll see this. There we are. I've been trying to persuade our cameraman to drop back. There it is. Nanny's been hard work knitting that scarf. It's only due credit that we do see the scarf,
absolutely,
isn't it?
Absolutely right.
16-foot scarf knitted by Nanny Arness. Perhaps she'll knit me one for next year now. Happy Days is the name of this entry. It's by Marina Sydenham Juvenile Carnival Club. And the music, Shout Shout, that's by Rocky, somebody in the replays, isn't it? Anyway, it's a juvenile entry, and they're really moving, and they look like I used to look. It's like a reflection of myself and you, Sheila. I can see you in it.
Absolutely, yes. Me, little plimp cells, the white ankle socks, oh, the whole works.
Oh, you know how to tease a man.
Oh. It's the white ankle socks, really, that's what it is.
Look at the haircut on the little kid in red. I used to have a haircut like that. I used to have a hair like that. I used to have a hair.
You used to have a coat like that, yes. So it's commercial in Bridgewater is their base. I mean, the float was designed by Richard Humphrey. The design idea came from 11-year-old Michelle Patterson. Well done, Michelle.
Yes. Yes, I had a coat like that. It was so long, I used to jump off the pavement straight into my pocket. I like this one.
The happy days of rock and roll.
They were very good last year as well. They were Russian-ish. I don't know if you remember. They had several prizes. The first in Bridgewater and
yes,
North Benham.
Yes, well.
And the first in Glastonbury.
Oh, here we go. Second childhood, Malcolm.
Oh, take me back to those happy, happy days. This is
Edith
Noddy.
Lighton.
Noddy and Friends, it's called. It's from the Waterside Carnival Club, based at High Littleton at the Wilton Rovers Football Club. Now, they've been in the carnival for 18 years, and here they are, the most controversial float in the carnival this year.
Controversial? How can Noddy be controversial?
Well, he's banned in most libraries in most places, and there's something about his friendship with Noddy that's not quite approved of.
With big ears,
that's
yes.
Right. Oh, big ears, that's big what ears. I meant, yeah. The black guy's been banned, and I can't remember his name. Golly.
They've got Mr. Plod, though.
Mr.
We'll
Plod.
Be able to see Mr. Plod in a second. Well, there he is, just standing on the side. Again, it's another two-tier float. Lots of action going on. There
There's
he is,
Mr. Plod.
PC Plod. I don't know about you, but my finish probably doesn't look like that.
Well, my little loopy loo doesn't look like that either. Yes, they're all good. They're having a lot of fun there. It's a lovely, clean entry. It's good. Let me see. Special mention there to Steve and Keith, the electricians, Kevin, Greg, the engineers, and Plum and Sue, the choreographers. Excellent. We're moving on now to the next entry. This is the King William Carnival Club, the King Billy, as we call it, of Glastonbury.
The first of our Egyptian floats that we're going to see the evening, a static tableau.
That's right, Joseph's Egyptian Dream, probably based on the Joseph's amazing Technicolor Dream Coat.
33 years in the carnival. Very striking floats. I mean, there's no action, no movement in this, but you still feel that you just want to sit and look at it. Very well designed, very well put together.
Yes, we expect high standards from the King William, and they've not let us down this year. Last year's magnificent entry, Le Serp, was great, and this is equally as great. I love it. Joseph's Egyptian Dream from the King William Carnival Club.
33 years in the carnival business, and that experience obviously shows. Very well done. Some of the floats you just actually want to stop and look at.
We're looking at the Five Seas Carnival Club. The Five Seas meaning the Chinook and Chiselborough Children's Carnival Club. They used to be that anyway. Now they're the Five Seas because they've gone into the adult class. This is their very first entry into the adult club, and it's called Temptation. Five Seas from West Chinook. And the music's up and running now. I like this one.
Very colourful. Another really bright float. I like the two tiers and the way there's a lot of entries I know tonight where they've gone in for extra movement. And they're based at the Muddle Man. 8 years in the carnival, as Malcolm was saying just now.
Fantastic makeup job as well. It depicts caged angels being tempted by devils and demons. Very clever idea.
Alex Samways is the model maker. Well done, Alex. The mask is absolutely marvellous. The giant devil mask made by Alex and Colin Johnson.
Yes, congratulations. Excellent.
Nice to see the detail again taken through onto the faces. Temperatures tonight in North Perth a little cold. Hot little devils.
They'll warm us up.
Absolutely.
I will look back now as another walking entry coming along, and we're totally ready for it. This is Jackie Kelly, and she's the Queen of Hearts. She's quite local. She's from 44 School Road, Monkton Heathfield, which is just outside of Taunton. A lovely little entry there.
And number 19, Adam Kelly. Completely puzzled. Very nicely done. Like the idea. Again, he lives at School Road in Monkton Heathfield. He's 10 years of age.
Yes, excellent entry. We're going on now to the Zigzag Carnival Cup. Zigzag, of course, another of the local entries. And it's a kind of magic. They were a lovely little entry last year, which we liked very, very much. It was in the Navy. That was did in the Navy by Village People.
Yes, that's right.
Freddie Mercury. It's a kind of magic. They're all little magicians with a rabbit coming out the hat at the front. Excellent. This is a great entry.
Parts of the magical world. Bunny rabbits in hats. Oh. Oh, a tentative smile there. Not too sure about it.
Yeah, they're aged from 5 years to 13 years.
Angela Perry working very hard on the costumes designed by Terry Pryor. Eight magicians and four wild rabbits on this float.
What's up, Doc?
I could tell you, darling.
Yes, great. I love that entry. Congratulations, Zigzag. May you go from strength to strength. The Rainbow Juvenile Carnival Club of Bridgewater, and it's all in a day's work. Now, this is a different characters at work. There's a school teacher and a little kid there with a red face. And in behind, we can see it. There's a soldier, a sailor, our best friend there, the traffic warden. Yippee! Let's hear it for the traffic warden.
The city gent and his bowler. Oh, very important, this tea.
The tea lady, yeah.
The NHS cuts are represented there.
There we are. What's that? A mechanic at the back.
No, she can't be real. She's a happy traffic warden.
I should remind you of the traffic warden in Taunton. There's a very happy one there. There's the tea lady and the bed lady. What more can you ask of any lady? Oh, we got a lovely, lovely little entry here. This is a Junior Monster Carnival Club. Wee Willy Wonka. Oh, look at him.
All the way from Axminster.
And he's 3 years old.
Oh, this is the Minster Carnival Club.
So he's the Wee Willy Wonka, and this is the Big Willy Wonkas coming up from behind.
Of course, their last year's entry was the Pink Panthers Cadillac, which is a very striking entry. They've done well tonight. 3 years in the carnival.
Yeah, well, they say best wishes to Helen's husband, who has hopefully managed to stay conscious this evening after fainting just before the start of the Bridgewater Carnival. And to stop rumours, she is not pregnant. All right, she is not pregnant.
Having a little Willy Wonka.
It was the generator fume. Well, we've heard that one before. Ah.
You chocolate man? Do you like chocolate?
Oh, yes,
there's a lot going on here. Bubble gum, you name it, it's all there.
I love the film. And the music. Rocky Sharp and the replays. That's a really big, colourful entry. My congratulations to you all.
With your golden turrets. Five chocolate mixes underneath. Every child's dream. Chocolate wheelbarrows, you name it. Everything's going on this float.
And they look like they've been eating too much as well by their waistlines.
Love the colours, very vibrant. The lime green, the fuchsia pink, the bright orange. Really good carnival colours on this float.
Don't forget, girls, with this chocolate, one moment on your lips, a lifetime on your hips.
The book was written by Roald Dahl. The film starring Gene Wilder, if that serves me correctly. Good interpretation, like the music.
We can certainly hear them here.
Another walking entry.
Yes, this is Claire Parker, and she's a girl's best friend. And that's Diamonds, my dear.
Speak for yourself.
She's from 97 Blackdown View, Ilminster in Somerset. Oh, that's a pretty little girl, isn't she? And it's a lovely costume.
Mother's worked very hard on that costume.
The costumes were made by Mrs. Angela Parker and Mrs. David Parker. That could be mother and father, would you think?
I would imagine so.
Yes, excellent.
TK Diamonds, that's taken some stitching. Oh.
The Western Zoyland Carnival Club, based at Western Zoyland. Whoa. And they are supersonic. This is based on the computer game, which is the rage of the world. Super Sega and all that.
This is a float for the kids to enjoy, most definitely.
And not for us, because we don't play the game, do we? I like the colours nonetheless. And I like the models.
They're based at the Sedgemoor Inn in Western Soylent. Music is supersonic.
The Sonics were made by Tony Ule. And it's Sonic and Hedgehog, isn't it? The Eternal Battle, the Mario Brothers, etc., etc. If you love computer games, you'll love this.
Sue Dunster, the designer, she's done well. Nice interpretation. Last year's entry they entered was totally tropical. 33 years in the carnival business. Nice colourful float. Lots of action, lots of movement.
The Gorgons Carnival Club from Chuten Mendip, and they are Crux Rejects. And there they are, all the dogs that didn't quite make it across this year. The music by the King, Mr. Elvis Presley.
Who said you need to be a pedigree pooch to be cute? Look at that face. Every home should have one.
Are you talking about me or the dog?
Oh, the dog.
That's okay.
He's got big brown eyes, isn't he cute?
There's a dog there with a bottle. Oh, it's a bottle of scotch. That's a Scotty. I understand. There's one with a sheep. He's a sheep dog. Yes.
And there's a couple of boxes.
Yes. The more you look, the more you see.
I like the puns.
And that's a little one with a toilet roll wrapped around it.
Rogan Shaker, Gorgon Gloss. Oh, if it's got a toilet roll, it should be the Anglex puppy, shouldn't
that's
it?
That's it.
Based at the Waldegrave Arms, Chuten Mendip.
And a lot of fun. Great. The 21st year in Carnival.
Capra Du Monte coming
yes,
down.
Yes, this is Brian Gray from Bishop's Hall in Taunton, and he's a life-size porcelain figure. Thanks to my girlfriend, Maxine, for the costumes and the support throughout the year. This is a walking tableau, and it's very unusual. You don't see many walking tableaus. It's the first time it's been attempted by a single masquerader. There, I told you so. Excellent, very clever. I hope you win something. I'll look out for that. If you'd like to know the winners, by the way, just look at the end after the credits. All the winners will be there. This will be, in my opinion, the County Cup winners. It's the Pentathlon Carnival Club. We're going to try and take all this in if we can, because it is huge. It is magnificent. It is marvelous.
Such incredible detail and workmanship. And our camera goes up a little closer in a moment's time. You'll see the amount of work that has gone into this individual float. I mean, when I first saw this float for the first time, the word that came to mind was, wow, it is excellent.
It's based on the film, the Steven Spielberg film, Hook, which is the return of Peter Pan to Never Never Land of the battle. And it's all there. And if we just want to open up and grab as much as we can, sit back with your mouth open and wonder at this.
I mean, they did well with last year's entry, which was El Cid. I mean, they're based at Moreland and the Thatcher's Arms. It's such an ambitious float, and they've made it. They've done it so well. You can see the details on the cannons on the side of the float as they come by.
He's just passed out. The guy has just passed out on there. I hope he's all right. Just fallen over. Well, they'll take care of them. They look after their own. On there this evening is a good friend of mine, Mr. John Field, who used to be the chairman of the
Models of Hook's Head on this, 3,000 lights in the
I was just
roof.
Looking at Bruce Sheila, sorry to interrupt you, there was a guy just passed out, we saw it. He's all right, they've taken him off and he's all right. Yes, it is, these things happen, they're on board for a long time. Like I was saying, Chairman John Phil was on board there this evening, good to see him there. Sorry to interrupt you, Sheila.
Yeovil's Boys Brigade Carnival Club coming up next with Young at Heart. There's one for you and I.
Yes, we are young at heart.
Absolutely.
Yes, they're a juvenile entry. Their ages are 8 to 16 years old.
Oh, the music by the Bluebells, reissued again this year, got into the charts. theme of hearts and roses.
Yes, some little rosebuds going round. Yes. Oh, that's clever, isn't it?
Yes, it's nice. A nice movement going around the float, something a little bit different.
Oh, that was first done many, many years ago by the Newmarket, Marketeers Carnival Club. And it's very effective, isn't it? You see, these things work, don't they? It's engineering miracles that they do work.
It's nice to see the original ideas. I mean, I think the kids in the little rosebuds is lovely. So we're just coming off the track a bit then.
We've seen a little jinx on them here this evening. We seem to be knocking people over.
Nice, the revolving hearts again, something else. It's just the extra dimension to look at, isn't it?
Yes. No, sorry, I was
Special
looking at
mention for Morris and Carol Lode, owners of the farm where the float was built, and also thanks to Sally Rideout, artist, and Dave Calway, the model maker.
Yeah, we're looking at Robin Hood and his merry man, Robin Hood, and Maid Marian. Excuse me, that's Joey Kuznitsky.
And Kimberly.
And Kimberly, yeah, you said Kimberly, thank you. They're from 2 Pulbridge Lane, Ilchester. Sorry if I got your name wrong, but I did my very, very best. The Cavaliers Carnival Club from Bridgewater, the Crown Inn Bridgewater, and it's magic. And that's their entry this year.
Another dose of Queen. Another dose of magic. See the hand coming through the centre. Four pens of hands. Holding the playing cards. Nice ideas on this. Very simple. Black, white, red and green.
Yes, an unusual design for a carnival club. They've taken the floor out and just built it all around the magic wand with the playing cards in the hands. Clever idea. Good luck to them. They've not had much luck over the years, so let's hope that they can make the big breakthrough now. The carnival club with a big heart.
Pete
the
Gardner,
Cavaliers.
The designer and model maker, I should say.
And the choreography was done by lovely Charmaine Slocum.
All the fun of the fair and the racetrack. Martin Pipe, where are you? Castle Carey crack.
Oh, yes, I remember. This is a bunch of ladies that go around and have a hell of a good time. I remember Pauling and the rest of them. They don't care if they don't win or anything. They just love doing carnival.
Frolicking fillies.
Yes.
That's their entry.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the girls. Yes, at least this Grand National got underway, didn't it?
It did indeed. No false starts. Do we have a small mess to clear up? Yes, it's good for the roses, madam. Don't worry.
Oh, we
it's
have
really
a barrel man
roses.
There. We have a barrel man. Their ages are 35 to 50. Oh, we're going to see a start now. They're lining up for the start.
On your marks.
I think they're under starter's orders. We should. And they're off. Crazy, crazy people at Castle Carey. And he's got a full barrel there. So
hang on. Synchronized horses here.
It's the music of Manfred Mann from the good old 60s. The entry is from the Pop Inn Carnival Club of Tatler, and they're just clowning around. Everyone loves a clown.
One to make you smile, one for the kids. Simple float, but well designed.
I'd like to say a special mention to their chairman, Mr. Eric Keaton, who has not missed a single carnival. He is in the archway of the generator trailer.
Well, coming into our view shortly.
We'll have a good look at him, Mr. Eric Keaton.
Happiness and clowning, the theme for this year's entry. Thanks to everybody who helped get the float actually on the road. And special thanks to Dave Burley for doing the electrics and Ian Hodder for the music. 11 to 41 is the age span for the Pop-In Carnival Club, Tatworth in South Chard.
We're looking at number 13. That's Lynn Tutty. Rain, rain, go away, she says. There's Noah and his arm.
Noah waving pretty shyly out of the tour. We've had the Mississippi.
There's a little Michael Tutty. He's the peacock king. Just being pushed gently along there. That's the way to do carnival.
Take it nice and easy. And coming up behind, Bonnie Tutty with the theme of Masked Ball. Very clever. It's the interpretation, isn't it? Our camera's going to go up onto this one, all the little masks, Venetian-style masks. Nice and funny. Oh, you can hear the music coming up. You can see it now. Playtime in motion.
This is the Springfield Carnival Club of Ilminster. And this is clever. They've got, how many floats have they got? 6 trailers all linked together.
All his individual carriage cars. This is based at Stewart's Hotel, the Shrubbery in Ilminster. Music, of course, this is the Kylie Minogue version. We like Little Eva, don't
Little
we?
Eva,
we remember
we
Little
love,
Eva in the Locomotion, our era.
These are all the little things you like at playtime, like beautiful blonde girls dressed in sailors' costumes and nurses' costumes. And
yeah,
for
okay.
you, there's
can
the
I, can
soldiers.
Can I have the man in the uniform, please?
The uniform.
Guy on the top.
That's right. Well,
what a little mover.
He is a little mover.
I like the cat. Nice. Costumes,
anything
thanks.
In a leotard for you, isn't it? They've got all the sort of childhood dreams on there. Clowns, sailors, cowboys, a little Alice in Wonderland. There's a beautiful little clown and a little guy with her.
Costumes by Doreen, Rim Toms, Karen Whisker, Marion Lovelace, Margaret Rist, Liz Thomas and Helen Halsey. Toys on a train. Well done, nicely constructed.
Gordon the Gopher.
Happy birthday to Gemma Toms, who's 8 years old tomorrow, Sunday the 7th of November.
Yeah, ooh. We're looking at Maxine Bogley now, and she's the beauty of porcelain.
She made
the Capo di Monte.
For the garden,
yes,
she
that's
did.
That's right, she did. And last time she was a springtime in Paris. This is Gordon the Gopher we're looking at now, and this, of course, is...
We can tell the Scottish origins, of course, where golfing began in Scotland.
This is Leanne Ahern, is it? Of Cummidge, yes. Last year he was a mouse-eyed view of Europe. And number 42.
Walking entry number 42 is James Bullock with Cracking the Ice. Nice one, James. And he lives at Summerlands Park Avenue in Ilminster. An ice jester with a large snowflake on his back.
Actually, that is a very beautiful costume.
That's a well-done costume.
Yes.
Oh, something to warm you up.
Yeah, we're on to the... it's going very well, isn't it, this year? The Globe Carnival Club of Wales, and there, Odin, A Dream of Valhalla. Valhalla, of course, is the Viking heaven.
Music by Bonnie Tyler and Holding Out for a Hero. Malcolm, where have you been all my life?
I'm here now, lady. Let's have a look, see what these people are doing. Their Viking heroes are killed in battle and taken to Valhalla with the Valkyries. The first Odin is mounted on a tractor, followed by the fallen Vikings who are on horseback for their journey through the ice and clouds to Valhalla.
Of course, in Norse mythology, Odin was the god of wisdom, culture, and the dead.
She gave me a lovely smile then.
Viking heroes who were killed in battle were then taken to Valhalla to be treated by the Valkyries, who were the daughters of Odin, who would miraculously heal their wounds. No doubt they kissed them better.
Oh, heal my wounds. I hurt where the sun don't shine. Excellent. We like that one.
Again, they've made the effort. They've decorated the generator at the back. Odin.
That's Odin out for a hero.
Oh! You said you wouldn't do that to
I'm
me tonight. You promised.
The Jokers Carnival Club of Ilminster. We've had a lot of Ilminster people through
we
this
have
year.
Indeed.
It's like the Ilminster Carnival coming up through. Anyway, back to business. This is the Seven Dwarfs and her.
And her indoors, her no indoor. Doubt.
She's a big lady, isn't
her
she?
Her underneath a skirt.
It's based, of course, on the ageless cartoon. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. There they are.
Walt Disney, eat your heart out.
I can only see 6 dwarfs. I think Dopey must
drink
have
drink less Cointreau, darling. There it is, in the back.
Oh, there he is. He's sitting on her back.
Cointreau kid rules again. Is that Dopey? Happy?
No, Dopey.
Grumpy?
Dopey had a yellow hat. Oh, he's got a yellow hat. A yellow coat, didn't he? Club captain, Richard Crabb. Good entry there. Snow White, Seven Dwarfs in her.
Oh, Santa's Grotto coming into view now. Christmas
yes,
is a-coming.
It'll soon be Christmas.
Oh, it will,
I haven't
indeed.
Finished paying for last year's Christmas yet. But
Hillview Juvenile Carnival Club. I should have less quattro. Based in Burnham-on-Sea at the Somerset and Dorset Inn. I mean, last year. Do you remember their entry last year? Come rain or shine?
Yes, I do. I do. But we'll get no rain in this year. And we're going to say, I wish every day could be
Could
Christmas.
Could be Christmas. Hang on, we could burst into it. We could start singing.
But I don't think we will.
You don't think so?
No, the music by Wizard, good old Ray Wood. There's a little soldier there. I wonder if we'll pick the little soldier boy up. There he is. I think he's singing his head off. Lovely. There's something magical about Christmas.
The youngest member of this particular carnival club is 5. The oldest, of course, 16.
But age means nothing in carnival, does it? They were Americans on parade last year. This year's entry is totally different. It's Droids. It's from the Randers Carnival Club off Bridgewater, one of the big, big clubs. Let's take a massive look at this thing. It's a leap into the next century.
It's absolutely marvelous. Ramblers have done it again. Droids is an original entry. It is very, very striking, totally original. They're based, of course, at the Bunch of Grapes, Bridgewater, 32 years in the carnival. Our camels are just... hold back and look at this. That is absolutely marvelous.
Now we're getting there. Now look at the droids there moving and dancing.
13,000 to 14,000 light bulbs they've used on this float. If you look at, when you come into view in a minute, you'll see the actual droids on the side who are dancing.
I think he's going to run our cameraman down there in a moment.
If you focus on the faces, and if you're a fan of the Red Dwarf television series, you'll recognise the modelling. There it is.
Beautiful choreography. That was done and designed by Julia McDonald, Julie Mack as we know her. She always does the choreography. Excellent. In 1981, they did the Robot Sky Bus. You may remember that from many years ago. And that won everywhere. They're hoping to do the same with this.
Mike Hancock and Andrew Kruer were the designers for this. I think they get an honourable mention. That is excellent. Music's right, colouring's right, choreography's right, the lot.
Yeah, we're looking right into the heart of it now with a little robot band at the back, is it? Working their keyboards. Excellent. Special mention to Norm Phillips. Ho ho, just another carnival.
Joint second, of course, in Bridgewater Carnival yesterday.
Oh no, not Father Christmas. That's the entry title, not what I'm saying. John Amor. And he'd like to thank his wife for making the costumes. Thank you. What
else? John from Lime Close in Froome. Too early, sir. Too early to think of Christmas in November. Oh, Marion Amor, Joker in the pack. 6 steps behind her husband, we've changed again.
And this is Tamaris Carver. Tamaris.
Oh, Magic of the Crystal. Yes,
Tamaris.
I remember this from Bridgewater.
17 Lime Close, Froome. She's 12 years old. Her mother, Mrs. Amor, made the costumes. Oh, and it's all the Amors together, isn't it?
Amor, darling, Amor.
Amor, we are together. Who's this coming up? It's the Mad Hatter's Carnival Club, of course, and they're caveman capers based at Wookiee Hall. What a good place for cavemen. Ha-ha, they dug them up.
They haven't got enough hair, though. Look, they want more hair, more muscles, don't you think?
Oh, you're into hair, are you?
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's the Flintstones.
The Flintstones.
Barney, Rubble, Betty. Is it Betty?
Betty,
and Wilma.
Betty. Wilma, open the door.
And Dino, the dinosaur.
The dinosaur.
Oh, bless him. Try taking him for a walk on a Saturday night.
Last year's entry was Oh, What a Ball's Up. I don't remember that one. They're based at the Ring of Bells at Wookiee.
Dino
nice
just going out of
choreography sight. Going
just
on.
Just imagine putting the lead around him on a Saturday night, taking him for a walk in North Petherton.
They wouldn't bat an eyelid at it, would they? Sam Vantra is coming up behind now. Sam Vantra, who were the giants of the walking entries for many, many years, set standards which others have set out to follow. And now they've set the pace for the walking entries. They put the respectability back into the walkers. They're the crown and the glory. Can you stomach this? That's what it's called.
Where does the name come from, Sam Vantra?
It's Samantha, Vanessa and Tracy, three young girls who founded the club many, many years ago. They've all grown up and gone away now. There you can see, can you stomach it? Because the faces are drawn on the stomach.
You do realise that that is next year's fashion accessory that we're looking at, the navel. Start working out, ladies. That's what it's all about next summer.
Actually, it's good faces, isn't it?
It's good, yeah.
Lovely makeup job.
I like the one that's moving in and out.
Yes, he's a little large there. Special mention to Martin Allen for the moving parts. That must be him.
This year's theme, what not to look for on a visit to London.
There's Tracy's mum there in the wheelchair.
The Chelsea pensioner.
Yes, well, she used to walk around
not
every
more
year.
Than Chelsea
she's
pensioner.
Actually got very bad arthritic knees and she would walk around, but she's taking the easy way.
Very sensible,
year.
Madam.
Yes. Yes, a grand
entry. Thanks to the Queen for allowing her guards to come out tonight. Damn decent of you, madam.
Ah, we're feeling hot, hot, hot. Can you hear it? This is a big, big entry from my favourite club. Yes, let it be said, I used to be a member of the Griffins Carnival Club. I'm proud. And through the bad years and through the good years, and this is a good year, it's the Mexicano Carnival. Oh, look at these boys go. They've won awards already for best costumes in the parades previously. Let's hope they can do it this year.
Oh, just look at those boys shake their maracas.
Oh, lady. There's Carmen Miranda at the front.
Absolutely.
That's beautiful, Jackie. The ex-mayor of Bridgewater's on there as well, Mr. Mike Creswell. It's all working this evening. The birds are going round this evening. Look at that thing go.
Oh, brilliant.
Let's go big on this and see what we can see. There you go. If you go to Mexico, you see these birds, Mexico, these birds are everywhere in the bars and everything. It's all part of the Mexican tradition. Let's see, there's a little tortoise going along. There's the birds flying with the Mexicans sitting on them. There's a crocodile at the back walking along.
Everything. A South American-style carnival fantasy. It's got the colours, the heat.
The beautiful costumes.
It is, yeah.
There we go.
We're
coming
up.
There's the crocodile now, or the alligator, or the...
Multicoloured crocodile.
And
moving
it's moving
legs
everywhere. That's great. I love this, Griffins. I'm proud of you.
We've got to focus on the dog, though. We like the dog, don't we, Malcolm?
Yes, we love to see the dog
wheeled
at the back.
Bedstead on the end. Two lazy Mexican dogs reclined in the sunshine. Siesta. Arriba,
there
arriba.
They are, laying on top of the generator.
Says it all, doesn't it? Saturday night.
There you go.
Too much tequila. Climb into bed.
Love it. Thank you very much. We're glad to see those dogs. We'll go on now to the Ghouls Carnival Club, and they're holding out for a hero. Ghouls, of course, are based at North Petherton, so it's a local entry. And that's all the heroes we ever dreamed of there. Let's see if we can
recognize.
Super
Mario at the front. Superman.
Superman is a Western hero. We all want to be cowboys, don't we? Lawnmower Man, of course, that's a very modern hero, isn't it? Anti-hero, really. That's the Stephen King thing. Lawnmower Man from the film, The Lawnmower Man. Spider-Man's in there as well. They're all American heroes.
Thanks to the mums for making the costume and to Malcolm Goodland for the loan of the trailers and the vehicle.
How many times have we said that this evening? Thanks
oh,
to the mums for making
yeah,
the costumes.
Important.
Yes, good old mums. They keep us going, don't they?
Oh, fantasy. Flamingo fantasy. Few ostriches have lost their feathers in the cause of this one. Flamingo Fantasy.
Yes, yeah, from the Bohemians Carnival Club. They're based at the Quantock Gateway in Bridgewater. They've been through a couple of rocky years, but they're now right back on top. And they say the rumours of their disbanding are absolutely false. So they'll be going from years and years and years to come. And looking at this, I can only believe it. It's excellent.
Headdress is created by Eileen Higgins. Model maker Dave Forbes.
And the costumes are Liz Hillman.
They've done well.
And now we've got all the colour. Mexico first, now flamingos.
Cricket St. Thomas, count your flamingos. Nice, nice float. Nice
yes, it
design.
Is, it is.
Rio Carnival theme, and the music, of course, is Calypso, Jean-Michel Jarre, that you can hear.
Based on an idea from the Rio Carnival. Which is a little carnival they try and run in competition with North Petherton.
I've heard of it, vaguely,
oh, no,
vaguely.
Nothing compared
couldn't
to this.
Couldn't touch it. Based at the Quantock Gateway Hotel, of course, in Bridgewater.
The Meridian Carnival Club, they're from Seton, and they're the land of the Cossacks.
Over the border from Devon into Somerset, they've travelled far.
That's a long way to come,
it's
isn't it?
It's a long way. Did they bring their passports? Roger's the club captain. And they've had seven years experience in carnivals. You can just see the domes there. Fiberglass domes, which took hours and hours of hard work. They're pride and joy, and I can quite see why.
Yes, and look at this. It's spectacular colours at the back, isn't it? The Kremlin-like, you know, I suppose it is a Kremlin-like building, isn't it? So that's where do the Cossacks come? Kazakhstan, is it? Don't call me Stan, I know. Because the USSR is broken up now, so it's an independent state now.
This is the club's second attempt to Tableau. They've been out to carnivals every Saturday since Seton Carnival on the 4th of September. They've won 11 trophies to date. Well done.
And that's the generator float, which is excellent. They could stand that somewhere and it's just on its own. Yeah, it really is good.
Makes me think of Brighton.
Oh, dear Brighton. How are you doing in Brighton? I'd like to know. Oh, no, I wouldn't like to know.
No, you wouldn't like to know.
Another
You'd
Mrs.
Really
another
rather
Mrs.
Not
Smith.
Know, Malcolm.
Wilfs, wow. Oh. Wilfs have gone west. Last year they were the Wilfs Classical European Tour, and the year before they were a sensation with the synchronized swimming. And now here's
synchronized swimming.
Had to see it to believe it.
Oh, right.
And here they are. They're way out west. A little bit of country western here.
Western medley with a bit of a twist.
They're going to have a little hold down now.
Yeehaw! Take your partners by the hand, swing them round, and let them land. Smile, sir, go on.
I'm hoping to see a really intricate dance routine by Wilfs.
Sort of strip the willow.
Wilfs, it's very
have
unusual.
You ever tried to strip the willow?
I was just saying, it's very unusual to see Wilfs walking and not staggering. They're usually blind drunk, but they're behaving themselves this year. Isn't this clever, isn't it?
Nice to see something a little bit different. Volunteer Arms in Bridgewater is their base.
Yeah, and it's good to see the guy in the wagon there. That's Jeff Paisley, who had a terrible, terrible accident with the generator about 4 or 5 years ago. He's up and well now, and he's back in Carnival. Good to see you. Well done, Wilfs. You're always a lot of fun. Great, great entry.
Cowboys and cowgirls with a difference. Taking it easy in the wagon. Oh, Disney. Euro Disney, do you think, or the original?
I don't know. You can tell it's Euro Disney because Minnie Mouse will have hair under her arms.
And does he speak with the French accent? Listen very carefully. I will say this only once.
Destination Disney. I like to think it's the one in Florida. But anyway, it's all the characters that we associate with the Magic Kingdom. And we're going to try and pick out as many as we can. I'll start. Peter Pan, your turn.
Peter Pan. Goofy.
Or you would know. Donald Duck.
Oh, I was going to say that one. That's cheating. Jiminy Cricket.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Mickey Mouse again, then. Tinkerbell. Of course, Peter Pan. Tinkerbell.
Snow White.
Captain Hook.
I was going to say D'Artagnan.
And Smee. The Smee is just behind him. Captain Hook's associate. There's Alice in Wonderland going round up there. Just behind Peter Pan. We can see Alice in Wonderland, the King of Hearts, and the White Rabbit. That's from the Great Disney.
Oh, yeah, the Good Fairy.
Tinkerbell, isn't it? Tinkerbell. She was with Peter Pan, wasn't she? Julie Roberts played her in the film.
Kylie Minogue and The Celebration is the music you can hear.
There's your favourite there. Look. That's Mr. Tigger.
Yes.
That's Jiminy Cricket. It was Pinocchio's conscience.
Oh, look, Cinderella, the pumpkin.
Yes, that's the magic of Cinderella.
That's Prince Charming. I want Prince Charming.
That's, what was that? Snow White.
That was Snow White.
Of course it was. And there's Cinderella on her way.
Coachman bopping for all he's worth.
To the ball. Nice entry. We liked it.
Destination Disney.
The Bridgewater Colts Carnival Club presents Guardian of the Deep. And that's some wonderful seahorses.
And a very in-joke there. No, we're not going to explain. Creatures of the Deep, Atlantis, move
they're,
over.
They're based at the Black Horse in Bridgewater. This is their 12th year in the carnival. They're a juvenile entry, of course, ages from 6 to 15. And there's some beautiful little mermaids that we'll be picking up, no doubt. And all the Guardians of the Deep from Aquarius. Or Atlantis, isn't it? It's like Aquarius, the man from Atlantis.
Captain of the boys is Oliver Bennett. Captain of the girls, Kelly Mitchell.
Oh, very diplomatic. And there's a little mermaid.
Complete with long, long tresses in the oyster shell.
The Little Mermaid was a Disney fantasy, wasn't it?
Yes, it's true. It's fun.
Thanks to their mums and dads for helping them, and thanks to Carol, the landlady of the Black Horse, and all the customers. Without them, they would not have achieved this year's entry.
All the essentials, seahorses and clamshells.
And the fact that they were vandalised by some mindless idiots just a few weeks before Carnival, but they put it all together and they're on the road. And he's back, oh my God, well, we can read that. Mr.
Heaven
Blobby.
Help us. Mr. Blobby comes to North Petherton.
Mr. Blobby's house party, it's called. It's from the Wick Carnival Club of Glastonbury. Wick are usually mounted entry, but because the funds were a little bit tight this year, they couldn't afford to do the style that they wanted to do. Rather than drop out, they've gone just dragging the carnival generator around and on foot.
Very inventive use of disguising the generator. It's nice, I like that. Pulls it all through. A very unhappy lady looking, has to be said, on the side of the generator. Oh, there, Mr.
That's
Blobby's happy enough for everybody.
Mrs. Blobby, isn't
Mrs.
it?
Mrs. Blobby, poor soul. Well, she's got that many husbands, you can't blame her.
Oh, well, looking tired more than angry. Special mentions for everybody in the club, especially Stuart, for being a chicken when it came to foul work. Whatever that means.
Dare we ask? This is the Limekiln Carnival Club, based in Bridgewater.
At the Limekiln.
At the Limekiln. The Vikings is their theme this year.
That's right. Last year they were in direct contrast. Of course, they were the pride and the glory. And that was all the things of England, wasn't it? Beef eaters, etc. This is the Vikings, the warrior race, and everything that we think of with Vikings.
Well, that pillage, that's what you're after, really, isn't it? It's their pillage that gets to you,
rape,
Malcolm.
Rape, pillage, and plunder. I'll be in the first boat. Here we are, Vikings, Viking longboat, the dragons.
If you've ever seen the Jorvik exhibition at a museum in York, you'll know this is pretty authentic. Look at them, fairly fierce. Again, lots of interest, lots to look at. Two tiers, revolving monsters.
But all the Vikings and all their anger didn't do as much damage as the Holland people did when they knocked us out of the World Cup next year, did they? That's a different story. This is Carnival and this is the Limekiln, and it is truly an unusual colour. Unusual colouring, yes. A good entry.
Swinging axes, revolving sea monsters.
And there's some beautiful graphics on the back on the generator.
Yes, this is coming into view now.
Just will we hold? They usually cut when we mention them. Look at this. Really great artwork.
Real fantasy.
Good one. Congratulations.
Okay. Oh, here we go. Everybody's favourite.
The Chester's Carnival Club from Pilton, Pilton's Working Men's Club, and they're doing the Bart.
The one you don't want your daughter to bring home. Bart Simpson rules okay. He's a cool dude.
Good old Bart. We all love Bart. I mean, every night.
Bridgewater Carnival. Everybody was bopping to this in the crowd.
At 6 o'clock every Sunday, I'm there for an hour with the Simpson families.
Every home should have one.
There's Mrs. Simpson with her haircut.
Very fetching she looks too. I've just got away from Mrs. Simpson, should I be worried?
And there's the whole family on the generator. Oh, we get a picture of that. I don't know if we will, but it's a lovely graphic. Oh no, we won't. We're
into
on
into the walking entries now.
You've got
Tracy
this one.
Allen and Push Pop. And Tracy lives at Penny's Peace in Froome.
And this is Sharon Allen, and she's from Penny's Peace in Froome as well, and she is Vision of a Saint. And this is based on a silver statue made by Johann Zeckel in 1709 of Saint Joseph, and stands in the Minster Cathedral at Freiburg. Very nice.
Coming into view now, young at heart.
And it's another Egyptian fantasy. Young at heart, they're now based at the Cross Rifles Carnival Club. Cross Rifles Pub, what am I saying? Young at heart are based at the Cross Rifles Inn in Bridgewater.
Have less control.
And their entry is Egyptian Splendor.
Second Egyptian entry that we've seen this evening.
Yes, we're very, very popular these days. What with Jason Donovan and
24 moving parts on this float with 9,500 light bulbs.
Did you say parts or tarts? forgive me. I didn't say that.
Will they edit that out later? Do you think?
Boy, there's some lovely looking girls on here. And some good looking boys. What's he doing on here?
Again, another two-tier float, as much moving as possible. Is it my imagination, or is it this year, 1993, that even more moving parts, the floats are more complicated, they're really good.
It is the year of the engineer. We're looking now at the Phantoms Carnival Club from Mere, and they're Disney characters on tour.
Mere near Glastonbury. Mickey and Minnie Mouse brought some friends to visit North Petherton Carnival.
Bless them.
Charming.
And
Mickey
Cinderella.
Mouse.
Oh, we've got the names of them all involved here. Mickey Mouse and Minnie Mouse, Pluto, Goofy, Baloo and Tigger.
Tigger, that's me.
Captain Hook, Snow White, Cinderella, Prince Charming and Donald Duck, I think.
Rumour has it that Captain Cook's a pretty vicious fellow. Oh look, going in on the attack. He's smiling, gives the game away.
As you said, that the alligator goes where Captain Hook goes, doesn't it? The tick, 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 tick.
Yes, that's true. There should be a time bomb, a clock.
Right, let's move on to one of the giants of Carnival, the Will's Carnival Club, who have dominated Carnival for sure the last 3-4 years. They're based at the World Worthy Sports and Social Club, and their entry this year is Cats.
Chose a lot to Andrew Lloyd Webber and T.S. Eliot, of course, from East Coker. They won a first in Bridgewater on Thursday. Quite see why. Set on a rubbish tip, a giant playground for Cats. If you've been to see the show at Bristol, you'll appreciate the work on the costumes.
Yeah,
and
Cats,
on the float.
Cats the musical opened in May 1981, based on T.S. Eliot's book Old Possum's Book of Practical Cats, with Mustopher Jones, Old Deuteronomy and Mr. Mistopheles. And of course the very, very famous song, Midnight.
Model maker is Wayne Anker, costumes Anne Vivian. The designers Alan Creedy and Rob Stoodley. And a special mention for Lynn Warren, who gave CART personnel a weekly workout for 3 months to loosen them up for some of the more unnatural positions.
I know why they loosen them up. I know why they loosen up. Don't listen about it. They loosen
over
their
the
right
bar of the Well-Worthy Sports and Social Club.
Right,
that's what they're trying to say.
That's right, yes. He's taking the empties back.
The famous grouse.
Excellent.
Well done, Wills. Another walking entry.
Number 33, this is Tracy Cook. Me, Be My Honey, that's what it's called. Tracy Cook from Wincanton in Somerset. Last year she was a Spanish fantasy.
It's a long way to walk.
She'd like to say thank you to Mrs. Anne Cook, her mum.
Let's get a special mention for the carnivals. Oh, look at this one.
It's the Hot Rock Carnival Club from Gillingham, which
We've
is in Dorset.
That's
a long, long way to come. And they're gone off the rails, like you said. Oh, it's a ghost train, isn't it?
Ghouls and ghosts rule supreme. Spirits. See, I'm on the alcohol again.
Yeah. What a really, really energetic there.
They are, aren't they? Like the ghost train.
Who did the music? Spirit in the Sky.
Spirit, that's just what I was trying to think. Yeah, Spirit in the Sky.
Norman Greenbaum. I knew that.
You knew that. It was your era. My mother told me about that. Hot Rock Carnival Club, Gillingham, Dorset.
Yeah.
bless him. This must be one of the youngest entries. This is David Grafham, who's another hook. Peter Pound's got a lot to answer for this year. David's from Wynn Canton, aged 3. They claim he's been 4 years in the carnival.
Yeah, well, his mum was pregnant the year that she went
that's
round.
That's got to be it, hasn't it?
Yeah, she's one of the Kingston kiddies. I know them all well. There's Emma Kingston following behind, so this is his, whatever, I don't know the relationship.
She's off the head.
Yes, Emma Kingston, have you seen Henry? That's the entry. She's the ghost of Anne Boleyn, of course, looking for Henry. Last year, she was a wave rider. The costume for my mum, Jenny, dad, Bob, painted the head. And Bob Kingston will be following just behind. You can just see him now from the Disney film Beauty and the Beast. And he's Lumiere, Bob Kingston from Wynn Canton. One of the great, great characters. Last year, he was Cafe Europa.
And, Spirit of the Sioux coming into view now. This is the YMCA Carnival Club from Bridgewater. Last year, you may remember their entry was Alley Cats. This year, they've turned North American Indian, or as we were saying the other night, to be politically correct, Original Americans.
Original Americans, there they are. A little bit more lively tonight. That's more like the spirit of the
Kings sky. Of the Wild Frontier, the music by Adamant, you'll recognize. Chiefs and Braves of the Sioux people. You've got the roof flag arrow, you've got 3 turntables, you've got the buffalo skulls, you've got the spears, all the essential Indians, you've got a carved Indian head.
And this is their 25th year in Carnarvon, their 25th anniversary. Our congratulations go to them. The choreography this year will be done by Denise Weber, lovely Denise, but I can't spot her anywhere. Well, I recognize
YMCA on the warpath.
Oh, Denise was right at the front. Yes, of course, she's one of the chiefs.
The essential ingredients, there's the buffalo just going around, the skulls.
I'm waving at the girls.
Down boy.
Sorry,
How about this one? Fancy this one at the back then?
Oh yeah, she's a big chief.
Absolutely.
Yes, great club, YMCA. A lot of good members there,
Spirit
a lot
of
good
of the
fun.
Zoo.
There's the music going now.
They're off. Well, that's quite a fun entry, I like that.
Hannibal Cook-Up, this is the 4th Burnham Brownies.
Hannibal Lecter, where are you?
Oh, here we go. Do you hear about one cannibal, he passed his friend in the jungle?
Oh, you promised. You lied. 4th Burnham Brownies.
Yes, this is the way. They're a happy little bunch of brownies. Oh,
now, what do we make of that entry, Malcolm? Bashful bride?
Oh no, she's with George Brinicum, George's Fantasy Grotto. We'll see George in a moment. He wrote a long, long letter about this.
George, a very well-known character, of course, in West Somerset, but in all the carnival
You'll
circuits.
You'll never read it. It's written in.
I'll never read
it's,
it.
It's written in Watch It that we can make out. This is a.
All animals banned. He's not allowed to bring his dogs in this year.
George Brinicum, who got the British Empire Medal. There he is.
Very
He's
well
a great
deserved.
Character. In, we're going to pick him up. We got our cameraman on him. There's George.
Evening, George.
He's as crazy as a 2-bob watch. But he used to walk around with his dog, but now animals are banned from the carnival. So George just drives around his little truck for whatever reason he's got. And the lady in front is with George. There's something about... It's a wife of a friend of his wearing his bride's, I don't know. Anyway, who cares?
Coming up now, we're going to see an entry from the Fleet Air Arm Museum Carnival Club. Oh, I love this. Big and hairy, long and scary. Get rid of this out of the bath if you dare.
Yes, look at it. If you don't like spiders, leave it. What is spiders? Arachnophobia.
A really original entry. I like it.
Yes, last year they were sponsored by the Fleet Air Arm Museum, but this year they withdrew their funding, so the club has to struggle to raise their own money. Tell us a story, ladies. We all do that.
A large spider walking down the streets of North Featherton.
Yes, it's good. It's very original anyway. Actually, it's so big we can't do it justice.
The lady revolving, or two ladies revolving on the top. The spider in the web.
Last year they were Snoopy and the Red Dragon. They're based at the Royal Railway Station at Yeovilton. And the designer, we think we should mention the designer, that's Rai Turk. And the costume's by Julie Masters.
Spot of Spain comes to North Petherton now.
España.
Olé!
All the beauty and magnificence of Spain.
Flamenco, you have a Toreador.
Yeah, this is presented by the Shambles Carnival Club. They're from Shepton Mallet. Last year they were the startling entry statues of rock, you may remember. And there's the Toreador.
Complete with Spanish guitar just moving out of our screens now.
And a big ole in the roof. The RBL Majestics from Taunton, and they're on a journey to Oz. Follow the yellow brick road, Dorothy. What was the name of Dorothy's little dog?
Toto.
Toto!
There he is, right at the front of the cart. You can just see him there.
Yes, that's right. And there's the good fairy, isn't it?
You've got the Wicked Witch of the East.
Yes.
Tin Man.
She gets flattened by a house, doesn't
yes,
she?
Yes, she does.
Yes, Tin Man and Scarecrow and...
Where are the ruby slippers? That's what I want to know. Where are the ruby slippers?
Right, this is Scarecrow wanted a brain.
The lion wanted courage.
That's
Tin
right.
Man wanted a heart.
That's right.
It.
That's a very, very good entry. Somewhere over the rainbow, you can see the rainbow. There's Oz and the magical Wizard of Oz has just stood there in behind you, and he was just a kindly old gentleman at the end, wasn't he? A great film. See it every year on Christmas. On TV.
There's a wicked witch if ever I've seen one.
She looked like drop bags, doesn't she?
Oh, yes.
Good friend, Carol Waterman from around this area.
Last time, Malcolm. After you, darling.
The Stansel Carnival Club from Taunton, of course, and their entry, it's Splish Splash.
Every bath should have a yellow duck. Not quite that large. Right style.
It depends on how big your bath is.
Well, this is true.
Well, at least some big baths for these big ladies, with no offense. They take a lot of water. It's a great fun entry. The song Splish Splash was way back in the 50s by Charlie Gracie.
Captain Rolt, aka David Gonter, the original founder member, still actively involved with the club. They've been entering comic classes in the South Federation circuit.
Now,
for the
now
last
we can
six
see
years.
The big girls. They displace a lot of water, wouldn't they?
I like the elephant and the idea of the water.
So now walk tinsel. Into the room.
Splish, splash, make it.
But no, there was a party going on. There was splishing and splash.
Oh, nice one. Splish, splash, the theme for Stansel's Carnival Club, of course, based in Taunton. Remember last year they did Let It Fester? I like this entry.
That's there with Eric Ware last year. He shaved all his hair off, didn't he?
Oh, a bit cold for that at this time of year.
There we go, this is the Chidcot Court School of Wincanton, and Beam Me Up, Scotty.
Star Trek fans,
Star
every
Trek.
One of them.
With a couple of Klingons
Deep
there.
Deep Space Nine, there's Dr. Spock.
Mr. Spock, Dr. Spock was a
Dr. Spock was a bit...
slightly different. Yes, there's a Klingon.
Holding on for all he's worth, yes.
Uhura, the technician, there's probably Mr. Spock. The Morning of the Dragon. Oh. This is the last year's county champions. I'm going to just say they have won 19 of the last 29 carnivals. Or, if you'd like another way, 14 of the last 15. This is the Gremlins, the masters of carnival these days.
Absolutely magnificent entry. Morning of the Dragon. Based at the Bridgewater Snooker Centre, 44 years in carnival.
They've got 50 moving parts. And it's all working. It's huge and magnificent. It's a Chinese warboat.
Medieval Oriental concept brought bang up to date 20th century by the Gremlins. Well done. What a magnificent entry.
On silent feet they came. You all recognize the music. It's from Miss Saigon. The Morning of the Dragon is the music. The Morning of the Dragon is the theme.
They have the colour. They've got the movement. They've got the music. They've got the choreography. What an entry. fun to just look at, savour and enjoy.
13,500 lamps. Gigantic. Are they going to do it again? Are they going to be county champions for the third year running? 3 years ago, they were in space with a huge spaceship. 2 years ago, or last year.
Our screen, we come back to Cockney, London, and the Lambeth Walk. Pegasus Carnival Club, based at Wookie. Anytime you're down Lambeth Way.
Yes, this is nice. For all the pearly kings and all the pearly queens. Is that Max bike race again? No, that's the soundtrack of Me and My Girl.
Yes, it is. Same song, different artists behind it. Based in the Pheasant Inn in Wookie. No turntables, no flashing lights, just straightforward, good old-fashioned Cockney Carnival part based on a market theme in Lambeth.
Yes, and it is good. It's very colourful, it's beautifully done, and there's beautiful girls and good-looking guys. Special mention here for Pauline Williams, the main dresser, and Simon Moody for all the welding. And there is a lot of welding, a lot of metal on this.
It's 100 foot long, they've used 5,000 lights, 1,200 cobblestones, and 400 pounds worth of plastic flowers, but the fruit's real. They're feeling peckish at the end of the evening, and they're ready to go. 18,000 buttons and a kilo of sequins sewn on those costumes.
It sounds like Come Dancing on a Tuesday night, isn't it? She's wearing a dress with 1,000 sequins sewed on by her mother.
And Malcolm's wearing a very fetching number. I like the pink one you wore last week, though. I prefer the pink one, I have to say. Doing the lamp thing. Hi! Touch of London in the streets of North Petherton on a November night in 1993. Oh, what a sight. The Cinderella's Fantasy.
Sorry, it's the 1 plus 1 Carnival Club from Ilminster. You're quite right, it's Cinderella Fantasy. They're based at the Royal Oak at Ilminster. And this is lovely, and it's unusual in the fact of young, unusual colours. Purple and white is the
theme. Earth moves. Very simple, as you say. White and purple. And it works beautifully.
The club president, Phyllis Hansford and her husband Peter celebrate their 50th wedding anniversary on the 4th of December. Well, congratulations to you. And Phyllis has been 20 years in Carnival. And she's one of the ugly sisters looking out the castle windows. We'll try and spot her.
Last year their entrance was Go West. They did very well. Second at Taunton and Honiton, if memory serves me correctly. Designers, yes. Ian and Hannah Burgess.
And I'm just intrigued by the fantastic colour combination. It really is an unusual colour.
Yes, it's nice. Proving you don't need to have a multicoloured spectacle to be successful. You can be single-coloured and very striking.
There's the ugly sister. I wonder if that's Phyllis.
Evening, Phil. Happy anniversary.
Or could be her husband.
I didn't like to say.
I was once an ugly sister in...
No, be careful here, Jones. Be very careful.
Two years ago in Cinderella. Yes, that was me, the ugly sister. You are watching Swift TV, the official presentation of the North Petherton Carnival. We're about halfway through now. I hope you're enjoying it and you're picking out all the winners. When the credits run at the end, you'll be able to see who did win this evening. Judge for yourself.
You were right. Starlight Carnival Club, very much in view now. Their entry this year, Pirate's Quest, based, of course, a dolphin in Ilminster.
Oh, this is excellent, isn't it? This is a little bit different version of the Pirates. It's just a symbolic gesture. Anchors
away.
Ship wheels, pirates, all beautifully choreographed, all working together. As I say that, the music stops. Thank you. There we go again.
No Limits by Two Unlimited if you're trying to work out the music. Nice piece of music, nice choreography to work with.
Excellent moving.
Yeah, I like this. You see the wheels revolving.
Whoa.
Girls bouncing up and down nicely in the crow's nest. Not too high. I don't like the height of a real crow's nest.
Well, there are limits placed upon them. They'd be higher than that. I know they would be.
Sounds safety, of course, a very important aspect of the carnivals.
You're right, there is a maximum. 18 feet is the highest they can go, and 100 foot long is the maximum length, just in case you're wondering. There are certain restrictions put on for the safety's sake.
Starlight, one of the biggest clubs, of course, carnival clubs in Ilminster. Another good entry. Pirates rule the waves of North Petherton. Skull and crossbones.
Oh, Jolly Roger. Here's one of your little favourites coming
float.
Up.
Here's mine.
The Puritan Pilgrims, based at the Puritan Inn at Puritan, and they are Tiggers. Just Tiggers.
T-I double gut.
There's a little collector on a penny farthing. And let's get back to the real business here. Let's go back to the Tiggers. That's more like it. Oh, beautifully choreographed this year. They've already won once in Bridgewater, and they're going on their way, hoping to pick up the prizes for the Comet County Cup.
What you've got to do tonight is spot Val Holden, who's the landlady of the Puritan, making her debut at the ripe old age of 51, they tell us. Evening, Val.
Wherever she is, I feel I can spot her, but they all look alike. That might be her in the middle. That looks like a bow.
Tigers are wonderful creatures.
Of course, Tigers taken from the A.A. Milne book, Winnie the Pooh, and immortalized by Walt Disney and his Winnie the Pooh stories. Dear old Tigger. There was Pooh, Tigger, and Eeyore. And they can be very, very proud of this entry. It's really good, really good. Beautiful models.
Again, decoration of the generator. Fat Jacks in view. Now, this owes a lot to Monty Python.
It is, based on the Monty Python sketch. He's a lumberjack and he don't care. It's called Fat Jacks, or Fat Jacques Lumberjack.
Red check shirts.
You can always have a lot of fun with the Young Farmers Carnival Clubs.
And last year their entry was Thunderbirds Argo, which was a really good entry. They're based at Seymour Farm, Stretchold, near Highbridge. They've been in carnival for many, many years. Youngest is 15, the oldest admits to being 30-ish. Eric Idle and John Cleese move over.
There's Malcolm, the Mountie.
Farmer Joe is their club captain, the designer, Steve Head. There's another naval.
I'm slightly worried about him at the back.
I'm very worried about him.
Well, he's in the head like a nice couple.
Maybe he's a Mountie.
Well, he's about to be.
I wish I'd been a girlie, just like my dear papa.
I'm sure that's Eric Idle. Starburst is the entry for this. This is the Merlin's Carnival Club, Barton St. David, near Glastonbury again. The music is No Limited by Two Unlimited.
And this is their very, very first entry into carnival. And so on behalf of Swift TV, Sheila and myself, we wish them all the very, very best. And we hope to see them in many years to come.
And this year, of course, their theme is fireworks. You see the rockets.
Some good-looking girls there. Where have you been all my life? I probably knew their mother.
You
anyway.
Tell me you were a happily married man. Does Lynn know about this?
Yes, she does. She knows I'm happily married.
Two rockets, of course, surrounding the car. We've got the central firework displays, and the generator disguised as a box of fireworks.
I'd like to say a big thank you to Mr. and Mrs. Phillips Cabell, and also Alfred Chinnock for the loan of his tractor, and to Mojo for driving the tractor.
Evening, Mojo.
And happy 40th birthday to Sherilyn on the 5th of November. She's on the ground crew, they tell us.
And so thanks she's now to in her 41st year.
Thanks to everyone in the village who helped them in their very first carnival. Our congratulations. Hope you come back again.
Absolutely. See you next year.
Last year, following a tragic fire at Windsor Castle, the Queen decided to open up Buckingham Palace to the public.
Times are hard.
Grill-Free Carnival Club of Ilminster have based their idea upon that. It's called Mega Bucks.
Oh, I like that. And there you go. There you go.
There they go.
You watch next summer. Remember these words. The fashion accessory for 1994.
That's the guards on duty.
Move in, sir.
There they are. The guards on duty outside the palace gates.
We have Queen Victoria on her throne. Palace gates guarded by five bare-tummy-faced soldiers. Two sentries. So we've got the corgis on here.
They're the corgis pulling the coach.
Are the RSPCA aware of this?
Admission, eight sovereigns. She's a little bit like Lady Di there.
The hinds are on the floor.
We have the royal family up in the balcony, if we could pick out. We can't let
hopefully
this go.
Coming into view, Her Majesty.
There they are.
Evening,
Her Majesty. Prince Philip, and of course
she's
the guy.
She's feeling well.
Guy with the big ears. The next
she's
king.
Goofy.
But I don't see his wife.
The hinds are out in North Petherton this evening. Admission, a mere eight sovereigns. She needs every penny she can get.
We're looking now at Super Rooster. This is from the Mardens Carnival Club up Midsummer Norton. They're based at the Mardens Social Club. And their theme this year is a Super Rooster, taken from Mickey John Bull. I don't know if any of you have seen him. You probably have. He's a local comedian. Rooster is his very, very larger-than-life, rude, emu-like character who goes
Super
around.
Rooster, you can see there on the front.
There he is, good old Super Rooster. He's very rude. Very dominating personalities, Mr. Rooster.
And a bright, colourful float. It's been the only club which has static turntables, we're told.
They have what?
Static turntables, we're told. Special mention for Jamie for making the model, and to Janet and Bridget for the costumes, and Lynn and Jamie for the artwork. You'll see the decoration on the
as they say, the age ranges from young roosters to old broilers, including she roosters. All right, thank you.
Freddie Mercury coming into view. The music, at any rate, Break Free. This is the Buccaneers Carnival Club from Highbridge.
They're based at the Bristol Bridge Inn. And they're about to start their action now. I Want to Break Free by Queen. This is a sort of a prison.
Could have played Jailhouse Rock, I suppose. A piece of music would have gone with this. And they decided to go for Freddie Mercury and Queen. The routine just starting.
Unfortunately, when they get into the full swing of it, they'll be gone round the corner. Never mind, we know what you're doing. Last year's entry was a European spinner and they won a first prize at Burnham.
This year it's the chain gang.
That's life, Pip. That's life.
Up one year, down the next.
Another tableau entry coming into view now. This is the Pariah Carnival Club, based in the Valiant Soldier in Bridgewater. And it's Make 'em Laugh. It's all the characters who make Comedy King. Right away, there we are, Laurel and Hardy at the beginning. You'll see them all on there. There's Charlie Chaplin stood next to Laurel and Hardy. Just in behind is Norman Wisdom. In behind Norman Wisdom, there's Benny Hill and his Benny's girls. I can't remember what they call their girls now. Benny Hill, what do they call them dancing girls with Benny Hill? I'll think of it in a moment. How about the cartoon characters are all there with a Roadrunner and there's Sylvester and Tom and Jerry. And the clowns underneath, the original Kings of Comedy, the clowns. Make them laugh. Lovely, beautiful, clean entry. Last year they were a Quest for Merlin, and they've been in Carnival for 56 years.
This year they won a third prize at Bridgewater. That's all, folks.
Hills Angels. They were called Hills Angels. There you see. Think about it long enough.
It comes back.
It comes back. The Commercial Carnival Club of Bridgewater. The Commercial Inn Carnival Club. And I can you.
Music courtesy of Bad Manners.
And there's some beautiful can-can girls.
And very fetching they look to, you know.
Three can-can girls in the centre of the car, three Toulouse-Lautrecs on each side, and a smart French tart on the outside.
Did you say that?
Yes, we do. That's what they
right.
Ripped for us. Yes,
not get in trouble.
Actually, I don't see the smart French tart anyway, but she's there somewhere, I suppose. There we go. Good fun entry. I can you? From the Commercial Carnival Club up Bridgewater. We'll take a long look at this one because we can't quite recognize it. The Magic Showtime is called.
Down and Shannon families present Magic Snowtime. Showtime,
not Snowtime. You've been on my control. I know
you're
Quantro. This is a little family entry. I know about six families got together and they're doing it. They're from Crediton. It's two families actually. They're all the children are cousins, and the club's only claim to fame is last year's float, Dizzy Bees, was seen on West Country TV on interval shots between programs. Well, there you go. And that's
white
a little rabbit coming up the hat there.
Yes, I like that.
A little family entry. Now that's good fun. Keep your family together. Enter carnival together. I'm loving it.
First time at North Featherton.
See,
aged between 7 to 13.
You can't paint smiles like that on faces.
No.
It's either works or it doesn't. And
oh, look at the rabbit coming out of the hat.
That's great. Holy smoke. I know that sound.
I know that sound. Flash.
Flash.
Woo. Queen gets the credits again for the music.
Taken from the movie Flash Gordon.
Or was it Flash Gordon? Which one did you see?
I saw Flash Gordon. It's the Newmarket Carnival Club.
Basic Bridge.
There they are, flashing. They do flash. They're little flashers.
Flash Gordon crashes on Zootos.
They flash everywhere along there, but they're flashing flash bottles.
Flashing members. 14 moving wheels on the ground.
They're always a little outrageous, the Newmarket Carnival Club. They're crazy people. They just go into carnival for the sheer fun of it, and they do have a lot of fun.
We're told to mention Merv and his revolving teeth and watch the bottom of your glass.
He probably have his teeth in
there. Will understand that.
His teeth fall out into the bottom of his glass. Oh, makes you shudder just to think about it. Wellington Young Farmer Club here, and their entry is Jungle Book. Very topical because Jungle Book video has just been released now. I'm the king of the swingers, yeah.
Rudyard Kipling, roll over.
Yes, we can see all the characters on there. And they're having a hell of a good time.
Mowgli and Bagheera. Wellington Young Farmers. This entry on your screens now from Wincanton, the Britannia Carnival Club. Another North American Indian, or shall we be politically correct again and say original Americans? Sue is their title. They're based at the Horse Pond Inn in Castle Carey. Two Unlimited have provided the music this time, Tribal Dance. They're on the warpath again, the Buffaloes. Make it on our screens at the moment, as you can see, alongside the floats. You've got the totem poles, you've got the eagles, the buffalo shields, dodo birds, tribal drums, the axes, the whole works. This is another two-story float. Revolving Indians, colour, music, the works. Special mention for Graham Watson, Kelvin Toop and Charlie Anderson. Thanks to Graham Birch for his major involvement in the Britannia Carnival Club even after his car crash. His son Paul wrote in to tell us about that. Thank you, Paul. It's the first time in 10 years that dressmaker Mary Edwards has been persuaded to go onto the float. She's there somewhere under the title of Big Chief Titty Witty. I say nothing. Seated there, she is seated on the generator. Evening, Mary.
She is a big chief as well, isn't she? The Honiton Young Farmers Club from Honiton, of course.
Now, the last time I saw these ladies, they were sliding along the grass in Burnham-on-Sea. We were against them in a tug of war, and very well they did too. Much more fetching in their costumes tonight.
Yes.
The music, Serenade.
Don Juan, the music by Dave D, Dozy, Vicky, Mick and Titch. A Spanish Serenade, yes, everything that is associated with Spain. I was in Spain last year, made some very, very good Spanish friends over there. I'll just say, hola, 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 Roberto, and Alberto, come Estefan.
Spot of flamenco dancing.
I'll have you be impressed with my little bit of Spanish there, but you're totally unimpressed. Took me a long time to learn that.
You've been practicing that.
Yes, I have. Yeah. That's everything that is Spanish in Spain. The dancers, the flamencos, the guitars.
There they go. Come on, girls, stamp your feet. And there they go.
There's a very beautiful entry coming along now from the Pratton's Carnival Club up Midsummer Norton, and it's the Butterfly Fantasy. This is really is a clever entry and beautiful colours. Little flight of imagination. Butterfly fairies, pixies riding on or hitching a ride on butterflies. What a lovely world it would be if this was all true, eh? There it is. Isn't that
short,
nice?
Vibrant life the butterfly has. Multicolored spectacular on this one. The wings.
These, even the
up
wings
and down.
Going
yes.
up in the roof are butterfly nice wings. Down. Yeah, very clever.
Oh, well shot. Our camera's got a really good shot there. You see it all up and down, revolving. Very complicated flow, very sophisticated entry. Well done, Pratton's.
Yeah, congratulations to Chairman Mark Coles for his achievement with the hydraulics on the float.
And they used a trial-sized paintbrush to get the detail on those wings.
Excellent. We like that one.
And we're told that Sid and Babs in the club celebrated their wedding in September.
Good. And the music, Hitchin' a Ride by Vanity Fair. Well, that was a long time ago, wasn't it? The music, the Ride of the Valkyries.
Another Norse entry this evening, this one from the Wind Whistle Carnival Club, based at the Bora Sports Club, Locking Road in Weston-super-Mare.
And it's another Viking fantasy. As we said, last year they were a Venetian masquerade, this year Viking myths and legend.
The music you can hear is Ride of the Valkyries. See the horses. There's also a dragon and two guardian dogs on the float. What a magnificent entry. Foot long, this tableau. You've got the myths of Norse mythology. The Valkyries, of course, as we already said this evening, are the female warriors who did Odin's will. You've got Valhalla, Odin, king of the gods, and his wife, Queen Frigg. Special mention to Andy Burton and Jeff Copper, Sue Pale and Alan Alte. 10 years in Carnival.
We can hear the music. Of course, we recognize it. Knights in White Satin. This is the London Philharmonic Orchestra version. It's a presentation from the Dolphin Carnival Club of Glastonbury, and it's in Days of Old.
You can see the Lord and the Lady bidding tribute to the knight leaving to take part in the battle.
Yes, the theme this year is a medieval court, and all in a beautiful jade green. Jade green and white.
Very simple and striking use of colour.
Yes, it does work, doesn't it? Very, very nice.
Based at the Greyhound in Glastonbury, the designer Tony Newport and costumes Julie Flagg and Sue Adams.
This is followed by the Hucky Duck Carnival Club up Colford and Dinotopia, a land apart from time. Last year's entry was a huge, the greatest show on earth, the big circus thing that won many, many places.
This year they won a second in Bridgewater with this float.
The scene is set on the island of Dinotopia, a land where dinosaurs and humans live together in peaceful independence. And a special wish to Amanda Hughes, Shape's daughter. Shape's made all the models. She's at present in Bridgewater, Bristol Children's Hospital, following a major operation. She's unable to see the carnival, but she will see it on video. And the club would also like to thank Click for all their help and support and kindness they've given to Shape, Glyn and his family. And from Swift TV, we wish you all the very, very best, Amanda. Hope
we
to see
indeed.
You here next year.
Get well, Amanda. Dinosaurs, of course, have been very popular this year, thanks to Steven Spielberg.
Dinosaur eggs, there.
Feel like baked potatoes to me. You feeling peckish yet?
Yes, I am.
I think we ought to put a plea out to Brian Bateman for a baked potato cup of tea.
There we are. Great entry from the Hucky Duck Carnival Club of Colford.
What's coming up next, we wonder?
I'll tell you what it is.
Ooh.
It's the Cobra Carnival Club, and they're back from the future. They're Cobras from the Fountain Inn at Wells. What's the theme? Theme Merlin the Magician.
More magic, more music. No Limits by Two Unlimited again. Interesting to see how the different carnival floats have used the same piece of music and interpreted it in different ways.
We've gone back to Dinotopia for a little while. Here we are, back with the Magician.
Straight on Merlin. Fountain Inn in Wells is their base. Merlin, not quite as you're used to seeing him in Arthur's time, perhaps. Beating on the drums.
And then I say thank you to Wendy, the secretary. She's known as the old mother hen and would like to congratulate the club for all their hard work, and they'd like to congratulate her for all her hard work. And that's it. That's the Cobra Carnival Club.
Back from the future.
Right, Cobra disappeared down the road, and then there was the most enormous gap. I've never seen anything quite like it at North Fedden. There must have been a breakdown or some tremendous reason for the gap. And we've hung on now, and we've cut out a long, long section of the gap. Just catching up now with Zango coming down the road. And Zango, pronounced Chango, Shango. And this is from the Masqueraders Carnival Club of Glastonbury. The crowd's a little sparse now, you can see, because a lot of people thought the carnival was over and they've all gone home. They'll all be rushing back into position because there's still some great, great entries to come along. And not in the least, Chango.
Rio Carnival is the theme for this year's float, as you can see. Again, the feathered headdresses. There's some flying model parrots in there. They have rotating fans, and 12,000 light bulbs. Chango by Masqueraders, based at the Countryman in Mere near Glastonbury.
All right, they're going to try and zip past us and catch up. And we don't know what happened. They did get a little lost. Sorry, Sheila. That's some beautiful girls as well.
Another spectacular float in the literal meaning of the word colour, vibrancy, music, works, the whole lot.
There's two sets of twins on the cart. Pete and Paul Vowles and Ian and Martin Hooper. That's unusual, isn't it?
And this year they got a first in Bridgewater.
Right down the road now, it's the Starlight Express. This is from the Harlequin Carnival Club from Ilminster once again.
Had a lot of trouble earlier this year, but the other clubs in the county offered them help, support, muscles, equipment, bolt holders, the whole works. Nice to see them back in the carnival circuit.
Yeah, this is based on the Andrew Lloyd Webber musical, of course, Starlight Express, which opened in 27th of March in 1984. And there they go.
Brilliant show.
All on roller skates, isn't it?
Yes, it was. I saw it in London. It's absolutely marvellous. No roller skates on this, but lots of action. Got a second in Bridgewater.
They are on roller skates, actually, but they're not skating around, is what we're trying to say. The costumes are accurate. They're all shooting past us now to try and catch up with the gap, but we'll keep it under control. The Luckington Carnival Club of Froome and their affair on the heath of the 1930s.
A real nostalgic trip back into the past, as it used to be.
Yes, with the little swing boats.
We've got the Dodgem cars, you can see in a moment.
There's the swing boats, the little galloping gallopers.
Shades of Mary Poppins, there they are, there's the Dodgems. All the fun of the fair in the 1930s.
That's when fairs were fairs. Well, the 30s to the 50s was a great time of magic for fairgrounds. Of course, it's theme parks now which have taken over from fairs, really, isn't it? Yes. Now we're going on to Kazaki.
This is the Domino Carnival Club.
They're Cossacks again. Dominoes
of charge. The Chernomen in charge.
That's correct. And there they are, the old Cossacks.
Siberian tigers.
Yes, beautiful models as well.
Boney M take the credits for the music to this, if memory serves me correctly. Rasputin.
Yes,
not seen the Mad Monk himself, though, with lots of yellow and red Cossacks.
And very lively and enjoying themselves.
Again, nice artwork as the camera's just looking down now at the cover of the generator. The Siberian tiger leaving our view in North Petherton. Another flash coming into view. Queen, very popular.
Yeah, real entry, not a comic entry. The last flash was a comic entry, wasn't it? This is a real feature entry from the Mendip Vale Carnival Club. Oh, get down, Mr. President. Fireworks going off here. That's good. They're from the Sherston Inn at Wells. Based on the movie Flash, where the soundtrack was done by Queen. A special mention here for Angie Dayton, Angel Dayton, who did the artwork on the car. Thanks to Mark Borden and Angel for the help, and Prue Webb for making the costumes, and Heather Smith for helping. There they go, the Mendip Vale Carnival Club.
Laser guns, the lot. 5,000 light bulbs, flashing lights all run by computer, a three-tier generator. Quite an entry from Mendip Vale this year. They're moving very fast to catch up, to close the gap. Look at the artwork again on the generator there.
Here's a big entry now. This is from the Marketeers Carnival Club. The Marketeers based at the White Hart Hotel in Bridgewater. And they are pirates in skullduggery.
What an entry from the Marketeers this year. Pirates, crow's nest rigging again.
Well, it hurts your eyes to look at it.
Everything moving. Feel the heat as they go past us. Joint second in Bridgewater. They deserved it. Look at the workmanship on that. Fire turntables, they have rotating skulls, action, colour and music.
Yes, the costumes by Mira Ball and Teresa Scobie, choreography by Teresa Scobie. Another startling entry from the Marketeers Carnival Club of Bridgewater. The
model maker there was Roger Murphy.
We should have another Bridgewater entry, and this year is When Movies Were Movies.
Renegades, yes, black and white. They don't make them like that anymore. Charlie Chaplin appears again, second time this evening.
Yes, and Laurels and Hardy, Stan and Ollie there.
The Charleston girls. Look out for Busby Barclay. Need a few more women for that though. Very simple, very striking, black
yes,
and white. Doesn't it work well?
Startling looking. Congratulations to the designer and congratulations to Sally Williams, the choreography. Choreographists, and behind it, the Young Renegades Carnival Club, a Chinese celebration. There they are. That's the sons and daughters of the Renegades walking around there from the Volunteer Arms as well, of course, of the dance. There they are as well. Oh, I'm out of breath now.
Chinese crackers, everyone.
Chinese celebration from the Young Renegades.
Keep us all nicely warmed up this evening on this November night, the Sidvale Carnival Club. from Sidmouth, of course, with their Caribbean celebrations.
Yes, this is warming us all up again. I'm glad to see the crowd have come back. They all sort of disappeared. They're on the carnival over. They're all back. Look at the beautiful colours on this. All
hot,
dancing
hot,
away.
Hot by Arrow again. Look at the colours. Really good Caribbean colours.
Caribbean, they call it.
Orange, lime green. Brilliant. Look at the movement on that. Hey, look at it go.
Let's hope Janet Beavis and Julie Austin don't have any mishaps, breaking light bulbs or losing their tights. That's what it says here. Well, I hope so as well. The Sidbell Carnival Club, Caribbean celebration.
Caribbean celebrating a holiday. Just think of it, the sunshine, the beach, the lapping waves. Ooh.
The Kerry comedians, pussies galore. These are a really wacky, wacky bunch of people. There's a night owls there, like you and I, Sheila.
Absolutely.
We'll be here for a long time, looks like.
And here's all the cats. They're playing our music, you do realise this, don't you? I'm too sexy.
These are the cats on the Hopton Roof. You hear them singing every night. And the Kerry comedians are really a crazy bunch. I went out and met them once, and they really are a fantastic gang. Just in it for the sheer fun of it.
Orchard Farm in Cock Hill.
I will mention Len Fennin. There he is walking round at the back. You won't see him. He's
88.
He's 88 years old. Yeah. There he is. That's the old guy walking along. Good old Len. Every year we see him. Of course, he was 87 last year. He's 88 this year. The White Hart presents the Dark Sword. This is the White Hart Carnival Club. And they're based at Midsummer Norton. Yes.
Dark Sword is the name of their entry.
This is based on the role-playing games that you get, you know, Dungeons and Dragons, etc. Special mention to
swords.
Mary Brighton, their first season as model maker, deserves a mention. An excellent
Absolutely.
Pegasus model.
Look
there.
At the horse.
The Chameleon Carnival Club, by the Sword Divided. They're from the Packhorse, of course, in Froome. And this is the story, the theme is the English Civil War. When brother fought brother.
Roundheads versus the Cavaliers, taken from the book by the Sword Divided. I know they've had help and advice from the English Civil War Society about this float for the authenticity of the costumes.
And of course, the last battle to take place on English soil was fought just outside of town at Western Zoyland, wasn't it? Battle of Sedgemoor at Western Zoyland.
We're a rebellious lot in the county, are we not?
Oh, we certainly are.
Hot again.
The Aces Carnival Club of Burnham-on-Sea are having a lot of trouble with their fire engine. They are hot, hot, hot. That's the name of their entry. They're from the Rosewood pub. It's up Love Lane, the Rosewood.
Lots of movement again. Simple float, but very effective.
A Caribbean fire brigade. And that's hot, hot, hot in the Caribbean.
Based at the Rosewood, Burnham-on-Sea.
And this guy on a ladder hanging on at the back. The Crusaders Carnival Club are following with their entry this year, A Pharaoh Story, the Crusaders based at the Duke of Monmouth.
Again, and just look at the heads. Pharaoh's heads rotating on that float, the work that's gone into that.
And the excellent choreography, look at the movement and the dancing, the choreography by little Dunster, what's her name?
Well done, Crusaders, another cracking float from the Crusaders Carnival Club in Bridgewater. Egyptian pharaohs, 58 years in carnival.
Yes, they're one of the oldest clubs in carnival, actually. And they're closely followed by all the Crusaders' young generation, and they're the little blue men. There they are. They're the little blue men. What more can you say about them? They're little and they're blue. And they're twins.
And very fetching they look too. Does their mother know their mop is missing?
Their mother is on the card in front, Cheryl, and that's Simon and Christopher. And they'll love that. That's a lovely shot.
Clutton Carnival Club next. Destination Europe. We're all little Europeans now.
Yes, we are. And there's all the people from Europe. All the 12 or 13 countries of Europe are represented. We can see onion sellers.
Can-can girls, you have the Austrian. Oh, look, there's the Pearly King and Queen.
and a Concorde. Latin Airlines. John Bull is there as a Welsh girl. Irish dancer. What do they call these dancers they do? Scots girl dancing as well. We've got a very sad entry, getting a tremendous cheer. It's a child's entry and all the lights have failed, but they're getting a, we could say, it's the Triangle Carnival Club of Ilminster and their Fantasy Island. Unfortunately, they're not going to win the season, so it's just merely for fun, and that's what it should be anyway,
yes,
shouldn't it?
Riding the dolphins.
In a fantasy island of fantasy culture. I remember Fantasy Island, the movie, with that little dwarf guy,
Just coming onto our screen now, the St. Peter's Carnival Club, the reign of Henry VIII, what a king.
And Handel's music, water music there. There's Henry VIII and all his six wives have come back to haunt him. That's Catherine of Aragon, Anne Boleyn, Jane Seymour, Anne of Cleves, Catherine Howard and Catherine Parr. Henry VIII, 1491 to 1547.
Jane Seymour, rumoured to be his favourite, but Catherine Parr was the one who outlived him. Henry VIII. St. Peter's Carnival Club. We change now to the Vagabonds Carnival Club coming into our screen.
Yes, they've been a long time coming, but well worth waiting for. Look at this. This is huge. They had a lot of light failures. In Bridgewater, the lights were all out. This year, they're up and running and working. This is excellent. That's
sequence,
clever.
Musical notes, movement, rotating floats, the works. This year's entry is called Bandwagon.
And that's what it is. Oh no! And we got Jesse Howes and Old Smith are at the back as well, Dad. So we'll pick them two rascals
up there. They are.
That's Jesse in the red coat and Smithy in the green. And unfortunately something did go wrong. There was a slight gap. I hope that we've cut it out so you won't notice it. We're going to say goodnight now for the second time. So this is me, Malcolm Jones, the voice of Carnival, saying goodnight to you all. Say goodnight, Sheila.
Goodnight, Sheila.
Bless you.
Goodnight. Sheila Liu is signing off.
Goodnight to you all.
Thank you for your company tonight.
That's right. Goodnight. Hope you enjoyed the tape. Goodnight. God bless you all. Bye-bye.